We have the following identities: cosine squared of theta plus sine squared of theta is equal to 1. We also know that cosine of u plus v is cosine of u times cosine of v minus sine of u sine of v. And if you have here a negative, then you have here a positive. Also, sine of u plus v is equal to sine of u cosine of b plus sine of b cosine of u. And if you have a negative here, you need to have a negative here too. From this equation, we have that cosine of 2 theta is the same as cosine of theta plus theta, and therefore this is equal to cosine of theta times cosine of theta. Notice that we are making u equal v equal theta, and we are using the plus 1, and then minus sine of theta times sine of theta, which is a cosine squared of theta minus sine squared of theta. But we can use this identity to write this expression in terms of only cosine squared of theta. We can do that by replacing sine squared of theta negative with 1 minus cosine squared of theta. And from here, we get the following identity, which is very useful. Cosine of 2 theta is equal to 2 times cosine squared of theta minus 1, or what is the same, we can solve for cosine squared of theta. Cosine squared of theta is equal to 1 plus cosine of 2 theta divided by 2. Notice that, for example, if we know that cosine of twice an angle is 0.4, then cosine squared of that angle will be 1 plus 0.4 over 2, which is 1.4 divided by 2, 0.7. Okay, this is if we decide to get rid of the sine squared of theta. We have cosine of 2 theta equal to cosine squared of theta minus sine squared of theta. And if we decide to write everything in terms of sine squared of theta, then we can use this identity and replace cosine squared of theta with 1 minus sine squared of theta, and then minus sine squared of theta. And then we get that cosine of 2 theta is 1 minus 2 sine squared of theta. And solving for sine squared of theta, we can move it to the left, is equal to 1 minus cosine of 2 theta. And therefore, we have that sine squared of theta is 1 minus cosine of 2 theta over 2. In the same situation, if we know that cosine of 2 theta is 0.4, then sine squared of theta would be 1 minus 0.4 over 2, and this is 0.6 divided by 2 is 0.3. Then we have these two identities, one for cosine squared of theta, another one for sine squared of theta, and we also have an expression for cosine of 2 theta that can be written in terms of sine squared of theta or cosine squared of theta. We can also use this identity to find sine of 2 theta. Let's do that. Sine of 2 theta is the same as sine of theta plus theta, and this is equal to, we can use this formula with u equal b and using the plus, and we get that this is sine of theta times cosine of theta plus sine of theta cosine of theta, and that means that this is sine of theta cosine of theta 2 times. We have that sine of 2 theta is 2 times sine of theta cosine of theta.